was good to deal with God's word, and even so much better for it, for to let it deal with us. So Psalms chapter 2, it talks about the coronation of a king. Psalm 1 and Psalm 2 was used when a new king was coronated among the Israelites. And it talks about why do the nations rage and why do the people plot in vain. You know, throughout the beginning of history of our times, even so much before, there has always been battle for power. Every time we see one nation tries to subdue the other just to gain territories, just to pull themselves up at the very top. And history has been marred with the bloodshed and conflicts amongst all societies. And yet, we see in chapter 2, verse 1 and 2, that it says, all the nations are raging against Israel and the king of Israel. Now, God had chosen Israel to be his own people. Now, the kings in those times were representatives of the community. So if the king loses a battle, the whole community loses. If the king wins a battle, the whole community wins the battle. Also, the second point for us to consider while we look into this passage is that when the wars would happen in those times, these were the wars between gods. It was not a community war. If Israelites are fighting against some other people, it is the God of Israelite who is fighting amongst the God of others. So it was not a normal war. It is the deities that are fighting against each other. And that is reflected in the society, in the wars, in the battlefield, when men would kill each other. So what do we see here? We see a sense when the king is being coronated, a new king is coming to place. A message is being sent about wherein the new people, the people of Israel and the enemies or the neighbors could hear that, okay, this is a new king of Israel who represents Israel, will fight for him also, but you better not plot against the king, because this king belongs to the people of God, whom God leads amongst all of it. We see in the Old Testament that God had chosen Israel to be his people. Israel was representing God at all times. But throughout the times, throughout the history, we have always seen that Lucifer rebelled against God for power. Adam and Eve rebelled against God's ordinances in the Garden of Eden. Down through the years, we see Israelites rebelling against Moses, who is God's chosen leader, and God himself. Further down the line, we see when Jesus was born, Herod was terrified of his birth because Jesus came as a challenge to Herod. In our times, we see our governments posing a threat and a challenge to the Christian faith. I don't understand why that happens. But if you look throughout the history, we see there is something about people of God. There is something about faith in God that somehow the governments of this world are terrified with. And therefore, they try to scheme, they try to make plans, and try to subdue the people of God at all times. We've seen it throughout the history. You and I are not